it is a good day today. And if you're wondering why, in front of you, you've got three watches there. And these are the watches I made a video about quite recently, what I've purchased and what I'm expecting, and they all arrived on the same day. Now, the two on the left, I bought these from eBay, and the one on the right, the Zelos, I ordered from the Zelos website. And the two from eBay actually had arrived previously, but I couldn't get them, and they were at the depot, so I picked them up on the same day that the Zelos came. So I'm super excited. I want you guys to join in with the excitement here. I'm going to put the Zelos away. It's the brand new one. Let's unbox that at the end, and let's have a look at the Steinhart first. So I've got the Steinhart here. It comes in a big old box. The box is similar to that of Seiko. You've got a top sleeve, and then you've got an inner box, which is, I don't want to say leather just yet. It might just be some PU coated, but it could be leather. I don't know on the box. So in the box, this is second hand, of course. So I've got the documentation here, and what this watch does, or the document here, it tells you what movement is in your watch. So you do have a couple of options available depending on what model you've bought. You can have a SW200, ETA 2836, a Valju 7750. This one in particular has the ETA 2892A2 Swiss movement. So as I said in that video, this is my first actual Swiss watch, or Swiss made watch. Steinhart is a German brand. So yeah, I mean, you know what, they go for around 620 euros, which is around £550, which coincidentally is the same price as the Seiko that I'm going to unbox as well. So that'll be interesting of what we get for the same price. But anyway, let's stay on topic. Let's look at the Steinhart. Let's put this away. So here we have the case. And there we go, the watch. Got some foam padding, Steinhart branding. Got this leatherette style cushion, and of course there's spare links there from the previous owner, and you've got a tag here which was on the original watch when it was purchased. So have a look at that. So this is the Steinhart Ocean One Titanium Premium 500 42 millimeter with 500 meters of water resistance, running the ETA 2892A2 movement. First impressions, you know what, I really like it. Let's open the clasp. Now straight away you notice that this clasp doesn't have those twin spring pushers, but it does have a milled scissor style clasp. You've got some branding present on the flip lock. And yeah, it is light. Of course, being titanium, it is going to be light. Wrist check for today's video is the Swordfish 40 millimeter by Zelos. We all know why, because I'm unboxing the new Zelos. So we can put this one away for the time being. So let's have a quick look. There were a couple of options in this. You've got the GMT variant, where you've got the Batman style bezel insert. I actually didn't want to go for the GMT variant. It's because, you know, it's no use to me. Because I was looking for watches, not to review, but to add to my collection. And I mentioned in the video previously that I want to get a Swiss watch now, or Swiss made watch, and just establish a different sort of benchmark in my mind going forward when I review other watches, and just get a total feel for watches out there, get a full comparison, because, you know, I am polarized to Seikos predominantly, and then of course the AliExpress homage brands, and I am starting to look at different things, you know, even micro brands, etc., just to see what is out there for the kind of money, and just to understand true value for money. So, you know, initial impressions, this watch looks really, really smart. I do like that dome sapphire crystal so far. I love how the dial looks. I like the markers, the hands. I really do like that ceramic bezel. Let's give that a rotation. It's firm, it's accurate, it's actually a good bezel. Nothing too different from what I've felt on previous watches before. And I think doing this, again, I'm gonna be constantly realigning myself, just trying to see where these watches kind of fit in. But I do really like initial thoughts. I love that case shape. I think it's a 50 mil lug to lug. So just on the edge of what the maximum I'll go for. solid links on the bracelet, solid end links. Looks to be decent fit and finish. And to be honest, the previous owner has kept it in pretty good condition. You know, there's a few nicks, few marks, but titanium does mark quite easy, I find. But you know what? So far, so good. Like I said, I really do love how thin those lugs are, and the watch on the side profile looks quite thin. Let's put it on the wrist. Bonus, he seems to have the same wrist size as mine. That doesn't look too bad, but it feels amazingly light. It does look like there's a tad too much AR coating. So we'll put this one to the side and start unboxing the second one. Enter the Seiko. Now, you know, I gotta say, I do like the Seiko Save the Ocean or the special edition boxes. You know, that's probably because Seiko don't do anything fancy for the normal watches. So when you get something that looks slightly decorated and nice. So you got the booklets, manual here, you got the guarantee card in here somewhere. Yep. Got some form protection, and bam, there you go. There is the Seiko Save the Ocean. Now, you know what? You can't lie. I mean, yeah, I do speak out against Seiko. I do join in the disgruntled Seiko fans when we talk about how unfair Seiko are being, how they're not giving us the right value for money anymore. But undeniably, to me anyway, that looks absolutely stunning straight out of the box. And that's because, you know, they've finally put the same specs, or they've given us the specs that they should be giving us. You've got a ceramic bezel insert, sapphire crystal, you've got this gorgeous Save the Ocean Manta Ray special edition Seiko SRP E39, aka Save the Ocean Manta Ray Special Edition King Turtle. Just have a look at that. I love that shimmer on dials. Now, Seiko's dial game is really, really up there. If we look at not just the divers, look at the Presage models, look at the Special Edition, the Snowflake dials, look at the Frost Monsters. You know, the list is endless, and I don't think there's many watches for that price range that are giving us similar dials. And that is, to be honest with you, that is the main thing. That is why you would buy a special edition or a limited edition, for that exquisite dial variant. Just have a look at that finishing, and honestly, it actually does look like, you know, you can see waves in the ocean and you can see those manta ray swimming in that. I think that visual is absolutely gorgeous the way they've done it. And under certain lights, you do see those little flicks of white, little bits of foam on the top of the waves that you expect to see when you look down at the ocean, and you see the little shadows. Wow, stunning dial. Bezel rotation, I mean, the thing with Seiko is the bezel rotations vary. Does it line up, the $1 million question? Yes, it does. Is there a touch bit of backplay? Yes, there is, but it's very, very minute. And you've got this magnification, date window, the Cyclops alignment. You know what, just looking at it straight away, it seems okay. It might be a tad off, but it depends how they apply it, of course. And you know, as we know, it's Seiko's proprietary anti-replica mechanism, is it not? The previous owner has kept this, has maintained this condition of the watch. It's in very, very acceptable second-hand condition. Now, that is a stunning watch. I do like the black ceramic bezel insert and how that adds a bit of depth to the dial, and it does seem to go really well with what you see on the dial. If you do want to purchase one of these models, or do what I did, scope one out in good condition, second hand. Okay, let's go over to the main one you've probably been waiting for. Let's have a look at the Zelos. Now, time for the main event. Zelos. You know what? I absolutely love that they give the whole package. I paid $430, I believe. This was before it went to $499, before the 5th of Jan. And you know what? It was an impulse, because I really was impressed with the Swordfish that I bought. So of course you know by now, the Zelos fans, you get the box. I love this box. It's dual purpose, you can use it for anything else, of course. Then they give you this watch roll. I think it's leather. Another fantastic addition. You know, always great value for money, and I think every watch enthusiast would enjoy these kind of touches. You get this bronzed out rose gold looking warranty card. Again, a nice touch. And this is the main event. Let's pull this out, and there we have it. So let's get this unwrapped. Now, first impressions. You know what this does remind me of slightly? Is just ever so slightly, I can see some similarities in it. Although in the pictures it looks a lot more similar. I think in the pictures the lug to lug looks a lot bigger than it actually is. And that is, this reminds me of that, the first 62 mass style reissue that Seiko did. Now I got it in hand, I think with a shorter lug length, it does look a touch different, but I, for one, can see a slight resemblance. So it's a vintage style, skin diver, no crown guards. You've got this gorgeous vintage loom application. I love the detail on the applied hour markers. I will say one thing with Zelos, I would prefer for them to use pointed hour hands, and that's just a subjective one, that's just for me. I do like obelisk, sword, these kind of hands that do have a point. Square does kind of put me off slightly, but however, the watch is awesome. And what you'll also notice with Zelos, they do kind of use smaller links. So you got H-links on the bracelet, of course, all solid. Gorgeous clasp. Look at that. Somewhat different to what we're used to with the flip lock mechanism, but I like it. As long as they give us quality clasps, I don't mind what design they go for. So they're going for something which, again, does look slightly retro. And what do you have? Of course, you've got screw-in links. Got the gorgeous black tip shark on the case back. And look at that textured dial, gorgeous texturing. And this runs the Miyota, I think it's a 9015 movement. So it's a high beat movement, a welcome change from the NH35. They seem to have got everything spot on. I mean, one of the main issues with, let's say, micro brands, and let's say watches from China, is branding. But they've got it spot on with that Z inside that circle. Zelos, it's a catchy name, no doubt. So like I said, they've done everything right, plus the extras. It gives you that value for money. Sapphire crystal, let's check the bezel out. Yeah, nice bezel, accurate, very accurate. It's at least, out of the three watches I've unboxed today, this has got the least bit of back play on it. So massive bracelet as well. There's loads of, I've just managed to slip this on straight away. Let's have a look at that. Yeah, that's definitely a good looking watch. Nice. I'll tell you what, they haven't disappointed. Great brush finishes, stunning indices, great dial, great color combination. Let's just have a quick look at the loom. And you can see the Seiko loom on the right hand side, Zelos in the center, and the Steinhart on the left. Seiko is super bright, Zelos is super colorful, and the Steinhart amazing. So guys, that is it for me then. I've had a great time today unboxing these watches. I will be sleeping like a baby. I'm gonna wear these watches in the upcoming weeks, and I will be reviewing them. Sadly, the reviews won't be here very soon. I've got quite a few watches to review in between there. But anyway, you saw the first impressions, and I'd like to thank you guys for taking time to watch this video, and I'll see you on the next review.